Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Almost Heroes on the channel. Today we are going to be back on the Dragonshire, and spawning for Team Blue, it's going to be Zul, Falstad, Zagara, Sonya, and ETC taking on Zul, Tyrone, ETC, Illidan, and Zagara. Did I say the first team wrong? Let's try that again. Team Blue is going to be Zul, Falstad, Zagara, Sonya, and Karazim taking on ETC, Zul, Tyrone, Illidan, Zagara. I think I skipped Karazim. I don't know. My brain's all over the place today. Hey, man, we're heading on into the weekend. Who really cares? Of course, this was sent into the replay inbox. Almost Heroes at replay inbox. It's invicta316@gmail.com. Of course, make sure you put Almost Heroes in the subject header. Also, make sure that you are renaming those replay files. Give me a little bit of a write-up in the email. And without spoiling it, of course, but try to keep them less than 25 minutes long. And just tell me why. Why should I pick your replay over anyone else's? I'm getting a lot more replays. Especially since I started to confirm when I do receive a new replay. It's gone up something fierce, man. That's all I can say. Falstad is going to die here. Nice little roam gank by Zul. Unfortunately for Zul, though, he is going to be kind of robbing his team of the XP that he could be getting right now in the mid lane. You know, on the bottom is going to be Sonya and Karazim taking on Illidan and Zagara. But yeah, make sure, again, people have been, fans have been doing a very, much better job with their write-ups. I used to just get a lot of blank emails and that was it. And lately, I want to say thank you to everyone who have been submitting their replays. And like I said a little bit earlier in this video, I do start to send the replies back whenever I do finally do receive one of your replays, And somehow Sony was actually able to get out of there. But yeah, I just want to say thank you everyone for the support on the series. It's been a lot of fun. We've had some great games lately, and hopefully this one's also going to turn out that way. Toronto hitting the Lunar Flare on top of Zagara while everyone's just going buck wild on the top lane for Team Blue. Team Red, on the other hand, trying to push down the bottom lane here. It's only going to be Karazim defending for Team Blue. Shrines are active. Of course, this is on the Dragonshire, meaning that both teams have to control the Moon and Sun Shrines simultaneously to enable the middle Dragon Knight Shrine in order to get the chance to become the Dragon Knight. Of course, if one of the shrines does fall during that time before the Dragon Shrine is capped, of course, that is not going to happen. They're going to have to recap it. Right now, Team Blue in control of both of the turrets, and control of both the shrines, rather. Zul needs to be really, really careful here. Zagara is also not safe either. One more Lunar Flare could have killed her. So a little bit bold there by Zagara. But Team Red is going to take control of the Sun Shrine. Down the bot lane here on the Moon Shrine is Zagara sitting on the cap. Now, unfortunately for her, she did not finish off the cap. And look at that. Team Blue is actually going to automatically regenerate that. See that black bar right in the middle there? That represents the threshold of the shrine regenerating for the team that does currently control it versus the one that doesn't. And Zagara did not stay out there. She pulled off a second too long there. So Team Blue will retain the control of the Moon Shrine. Meanwhile, back up here in the top lane, Taranda missing the Lunar Flare, but then landing the sentry. So much damage from Taranda. Been seeing a lot of Taranda play lately. She's good, man. She's very, very good. Don't underestimate Tyrone. She'll put you in your place. ETC walking into, unbeknownst to him, a 3v1. He's trying to power slide away. He actually clipped the corner of the bushes. He is going to go down. I think they're going to be... No, they did not. They weren't able to get Falstad right at the very end, thanks to Barrel Roll, of all things, giving him a little bit of protection against Taranda's basic attack. Meanwhile, Illidan going one-on-one down here with Sonya. The Roach is trying to help out as well. Team Blue again controlling the Dragon Shrines. But unfortunately for them, they do not have complete control of the mid lane. It's going to be a Zul off in the mid lane. Meanwhile, Karazim, what he... I don't know what Karazim thought was going to happen there. Illidan's going to chase him. He's going to be able to get the kill. Get down goes Karazim. Team Red did take control of the Sun Shrine. Taranda was killed in the mid lane here. Falstad also going after Zul. Zul's also going to fall. Nice job by ETC. He was able to get the stun right in front of the turret. Very nicely done there with the power slide face melter combo. Sonya going back and forth here down the bot lane with Illidan Zagara. She might be able to get a kill on Illidan. She was, but then she gets... she did get taken out by the turret there. Nice little bone prison for Zul just to get away from ETC. Been seeing a lot of people playing ETC a lot lately too, which is kind of surprising considering ETC didn't really go through too many changes as of late, at least not to my knowledge anyway. I have to check my Invicta patch notes videos to make sure that's an accurate statement. So after 4 minutes here, it's tied literally all up except for the level sixes all over the place. Team Blue is up by one level here. It's at level 7. ETC sliding in from the mid. Meanwhile, Taranda and Zul are going to try to fight off that Hydralisk. But again, down in the bottom lane here, it's all going to be Team Blue. Neither team really able to control both shrines for very long. It was only Team Blue who did have simultaneous control briefly, but Team Red Zul was able to keep them off of the cap in the mid lane. So Zagara is stalking along the Sun Shrine here. She's going to try to take advantage of it. She does know that ETC is coming around the side. I don't think she'll be in too much trouble. Even if Taranda had landed that Lunar Flare, I think she would have been okay. Although, she's taking a lot of damage here. She sat there and wanted to fight one-on-one with Taranda. Falstad coming over here from the top lane as well to try to help out Zagara, who's forced to go backwards. And then she decides not to go backwards. I think it's safe for Zagara right now to go back. I don't really see any problem with that. She needs to be very, very cautious. She doesn't get picked off, however. One Lunar Flare could be the end of her. Now she's lost that much HP. Sonya still controlling the Moon Shrine back up here to the top lane. Zul roamed in from the mid lane, landed the Bone Prison, but unfortunately for him, there's no follow-ups. Too close to the turrets. Probably a wise move there by Team Red not to try to follow through on that. Karzeem also coming in from the middle. ETC using the face melter to just knock Falstad away. There goes the Bone Prison. It's going to be landing on Zul. It's going to be a Zul off. Taranda did land the Lunar Flare, but again, not much done. The only damage that was up there is really Falstad. Both Zuls are kind of beaten on each other, and then it's just going to be Karzeem and Taranda just kind of having a support off. So Team Red finally gaining control of both shrines simultaneously briefly there, but again, it is going to be recapped by Team Blue up in the top lane at the Sun Shrine. ETC getting swarmed on by everybody. Zagara, Karzeem, and Zul. Down goes ETC, so the power play is going to go back in favor of Team Blue now, who still maintain that one-level lead. And it's been, honestly, a real back-and-forth volley here on the bottom lane. It goes to Team Red, then Blue, then Red, then Blue. Team Blue has controlled the top lane for the most part, and actually Karzeem and Zagara are actually going to try to start pushing this down. They did take down the walls and both turrets. Sonya should be okay here. Well, unless she decides to turn around. Somebody pinging like they're on their way. Most likely that was the Blue players, that was Team Blue's Zul. Meanwhile, up in the top lane. Oh, Zagara landing the two-person maul. Unfortunately, though, she threw out the Banelings a little bit too early. Team Blue did get their heroics here before Team Red. Red's still about half a level away. ETC needs to be really careful there. He's going to eat a bunch of Banelings right to the face. Nice follow-up stun there by Taranda, but I don't think they have enough DPS right now to bring down Karzeem. Meanwhile, ETC is getting taken down by Zagara. That's so much damage. Team Blue was somehow able to get the Dragon Knight. I was too busy looking at the top lane fight. I didn't even realize that Team Blue was even trying to cap that. So the Dragon Knight currently romping and stomping in the middle here. Yeah, this is going to be a somewhat powerful Dragon Knight. I mean, it is around a level 11 right now. Team Red did get their heroics. I don't think Blue is going to be able to do that much with this Dragonite, especially considering that none of the rest of the team are trying to help push this, except for Zul, who's being accosted right now by Illidan. Zul's going to be in a lot of trouble. He is going to get taken out. Maybe, maybe not. Bone Shield trying to mitigate a lot of that damage, but yeah, Illidan's able to take him down. Down goes Zul. The Dragonite was able to get the tower, the fort turret, and that was about it. Zagara, meanwhile, sitting up there in the top lane, just trying to do a little bit of a split push. Unfortunately for her, she just didn't have it. Karzeem over there. Well, actually, no, they're still going to be able to deal quite a bit of damage. I think Karzeem's pretty much pot committed. He used seven-sided strike to get away, but that's only gonna delay the inevitable there. Meanwhile, we have Sonya still solo pushing down the bot lane as well. So just pushing all over the place here. The only bright side for Team Red so far has been this middle push by Zul, and that is about it. Sonya was killed down the bottom lane, thanks to Illidan and Zagara. So after the first Dragonite at 8 minutes here, it's going to be 7-10 in favor of Team Red. But Team Blue is the one who was the benefactor of the very first Dragonite. Surprisingly, no structures have fallen. As long as you don't consider the turrets or the wall as a structure, which I really feel like they probably should be. At least count the turrets or something like that, because turrets are kind of important. Zagara did not get a peek at Zul there, as Team Blue going to go after their own Siege Giants. Meanwhile, Illidan and Zagara pushing down the bot lane again. It looked like Taranda, judging from the minimap, looked like she wanted to go for the Night Camp. Ends up, she didn't get any help for that. There's the Hinterlands Blast landing right on top of Zagara. Oh, what a nice swap with the Maul, but unfortunately she was hit by the Bone Prison. Down goes Zagara, power play in favor of Team Blue. There's the Skeletal Mages thrown out. There's a double Skeletal Mages into the Mosh Pit. A huge, huge Mosh Pit by ETC. Somehow no one's died. Finally, Falstad did go down. Seven-sided strike landing on ETC. Illidan's going to jump on in there with the hunt, and it's only been two deaths, if you can believe it here. Oh, Sonya's so close. Down goes ETC. I don't know why Zul decided to go back, and Zul gets launched 30 feet into the air. He's going to fall. Down goes Sonya. It's down to Illidan and Karzeem. Meanwhile, Zagara is untouched, up and back and up in the top lane for Team Blue. Karzeem and Illidan squaring off. Illidan ends up beating the support, and I'm glad that he did because I would have felt really bad as an Illidan player. Wow, what a long team fight. That team fight seriously lasted about 90 seconds. So much death now. 10 to 14 in favor of Team Red, but you do see the Team Blue is going to be the first to draw blood on the structures as they do get the top lane thanks to the split push by Zagara. Not really a split push. It was more like a solo push while the rest of the team was fighting down the bot lane. Team Blue does control both of the shrines right now. Zagara taking a lot of damage from Falstad. Falstad, however, I'm not sure if he didn't realize that Illidan was there or just didn't care. But he's going to get completely mollywopped. Zul trying to cap it. Oh, just barely not able to cap it. Nice job by Illidan to make sure he regained control of the Moon Shrine before Zul could do that. ETC trying to gain control of the Sun Shrine. It is going to go right over that threshold there, but unfortunately for him, he's let Zagara get over there a tick too late, and it's going to start regenerating for Team Blue. Sonya jumping in, a 3v1. There's the Skeletal Mages. I'm not sure who's... I think that was going to be the red player, Zul, who threw out the Skeletal Mages. So again, another power play in favor of Team Red here, as Sonya's going to be down for another 28 seconds. Again, control of the Moon Shrine, but the Sun Shrine still being fought over by ETC and Zagara, just doing the round to loop-de-loop. Cue the Benny Hill music as ETC is still trying to wrangle up Zagara. Zagara taking surprising amounts of damage from ETC. All she has to do is land the Banelings. That's all she got to do is land. She missed him. Zagara with the Whifflings. ETC able to take her down. The Roaches are not going to be enough. All you had to do was land the Banelings, Zagara. It would have been easy. Oh, it's all right. Team Red losing control of the Moon Shrine almost immediately. Falstad was killed down in the bot lane. Zul was also going to go down here. Unfortunately for him, he did not take Poison Nova. Karzeem doing a surprising amount of damage to Zul, and he might actually get the kill. One more hit. He uses the... Oh, so close. He's not going to be able to make it. Zul landed the Bone Prison, and that's going to be a dead Karzeem. Oh, man. ETC is going to grab the Dragon Knight here for Team Red. I don't know how Karzeem ended up not getting that kill. Circle of healing, it looked like he hesitated just a second. And that was long enough for Zul to throw out the Bone Prison and get him stuck inside of that turret range. Either way, power play now greatly in favor of Team Red. The tune of 5v3, up by 2 levels and 10 kills. Surprisingly, they still have not taken down a fortress or a structure yet, but looks like the middle fort is going to fall here momentarily. Illidan did get hit pretty hard by Sonya. There's the Hinterlands Blast taking down Illidan, and the first fort is going to fall finally for Team Blue, evening up structures 5-5. Dragon Knight coming out, still fighting on, basically trying to kill Zul of all people. Going to get the Puntarino on Zagara Reno, but that was going to be it. Nice little follow through here by Team Red. They were able to get the middle fort, Seven Sided Strike landing on everyone but the Dragon Knight. This fight's still not over. Falstad is going to go down. I'm not sure why he decided to overextend a little bit too much there with no HP. Nice punt away there by the Dragon Knight. It is going to get canceled out finally. So after the second Dragon Knight here, the 12.5-minute mark, it's Team Red up by 11 kills, evening it up on the structure, going up by 2 levels. ETC landing the 3-man mosh pit, but there's no damage. That's the problem here. Both Zagara is throwing off simultaneous Banelings, and Zagara is going to fall. Again, another power play in favor of Team Red. Look at that. How often have you ever seen a team actually take a fight to the Skeletal Mages and eliminate them? That might be the first time I've ever seen that. Karzeem jumping in on top of Zul here. Sonya whirlwinding the best she can, but still a power play in favor of Team Red. Another huge maw. Let's see if Zagara can land it this time. Can she? No. Way too late. Karzeem ends up getting killed anyway, and I think that Sonya is also going to go down. She did activate the Hardened Shield, or Stone Skin rather, but that's not going to be enough to take her through that fight. She did also activate Wrath Berserker, and it was the the Mutalisk taking down, at least I believe that was a Mutalisk anyway, taking down Sonya there. Zagara getting a kill, and I don't even think Zagara even realized that. So another super long team fight there after that Dragon Knight, but still going to be Team Red in favor, largely, by the way, of 14 kills and still almost 3 levels up. Looks like Blue Zagara may have had enough. We'll have to wait and find out. You want Zagara and Falstad taking down their own Night Camp on the blue side of the map. But 11-25, one structure down for each. The bottom four is almost dead here for Team Red. They've got to be careful. But that Alzul just barely got back in time. I think if he would have lasted a half second longer, he would have been pounced on by the entirety of Team Red down in the bottom lane here. Trying to protect their Siege Giants. They're doing a lot of damage to the fort. There's Seven Strider Strike going out and landing on Zul, but not doing enough damage. Sonya launching her attack here with Age of Spear right after casting Wrath Berserker. Didn't even get a whirlwind off yet anyway. Now she's going to try to tee off on Zagara. Zagara is going to fall. Illidan's going to be just barely able to take down Karzeem thanks to the help of the Night Camp. Illidan's still brawling, taking down Sonya as well, and now he's going after Zul. Team Red able to land the Bone Prison, but Illidan not willing to risk to go fight Zul underneath the turret, and I don't blame him, but again, another huge power play, 2-1 in favor of Team Red right now. Super long power slide by ETC is going to land right on the money. Zagara is going to fall here. Somehow she was able to get the Maw off. Falstad brawling with ETC, but the fact of the matter is Zul is going to be trying to take the Dragon Knight. He is going to be able to get it. Falstad getting the Absorption Shield from using Barrel Roll, but that's not going to help him that much. This is going to be a much more powerful Dragon Knight as we see the second fort fall down in the bottom lane. So now Team Red starting to run away with this one. They've got their Storm Talents here at level 20. And it's only going to be the lone, it's going to be lone ETC right now. Not ETC, sorry. That's, I think that's their Zul player. Team Blue Zul throwing out the Skeletal Mages to try to zone out the Dragon Knight. And actually the Dragon Knight doing a little bit too much brawling. He needs to just go right for the structures. He could have had that keep down by now if he was just basic attacking. Instead, he wanted to fight a little bit. He's costing his team precious damage on the keep. They are going to be able to get it, but that could have gone down about maybe 10 seconds sooner. You heard that announcement that Team Blue's core is starting to take some damage there. As Team Red going to be sending off the the catapults. ETC having a one cow mosh pit. So there you go. He's not a cow. He's a bull. And speaking of one cow mosh pits, there's a one-man maw. Thrown out by Zagara. I think ETC is barely going to escape thanks to Power Slide. Taranda getting left in the dust by her team. She does not have Shadow Stalk up quite yet. Karzeem throwing down a blue healing ward there. They're still chasing Taranda. Able to land the Lunar Flare. I don't think she's going to be able to get away. There you go. Down goes Taranda finally. The Dragon Knight did finally expire. He was not able to get another structure. ETC goes down. So a huge turnaround for Team Blue as they're now looking at a 5-2 power play. This whole counterattack is pretty fierce. I've got to say, in the middle, it's only going to be Zul and Zagara. Zul tossing out the Skeletal Mages on literally everyone on Team Blue, but is that going to be enough? Seven-Sided Strike casted on Zul, doing a lot of damage. Sonya is almost dead from the Mutalisk. That Mutalisk is still going after Sonya. Zul is taken out. I think the creep is going to be able to take down the Mutalisk finally, yeah. So it's still going to be a 4-for-none scam so far for Team Blue. And a very fierce counterattack. Even though they're down by 13 kills, they've evened up the score as far as the structures are concerned. They also catch right back up in the levels, level 20, level 21. That's basically a non-existent lead at this point, except for a little bit of stats. Oh, Sonya's got to be so careful. Sonya, what are you doing? Sonya had like 5 HP left. She gets taken out by a very opportunistic Illidan. Now, Illidan does have the hunt. He did not go for nowhere to hide, though, I don't think, anyway. Down goes Zagara and Illidan there. I don't even think Zagara needed to use the Maw. So it doesn't matter now. Illidan can't use the hunt while he's dead. And again, seemingly down against the ropes here after that last Dragonite, Team Blue able to sustain themselves, and not only that, but stabilize and start pushing Team Red back, getting a lot of kills. So right now, it's anyone's ball game. Taranda throwing out the Lunar Flare. Oh, what a nice route by Zul. Down goes Taranda. She was able to get Shadowstalk off just in time just to protect ETC, but what is ETC going to do against an entire team? And it's going to come down to this Dragon Knight here. If Team Blue can get this while they've got the power play, I don't think there's any way that the two members of Team Red who are alive right now are going to be able to stop it. But then Falstad dies. He ended up sticking around a little bit too long. And will ETC be able to get to the Dragon Knight to stop the cap? He has to get there. Can he stop Zagara? He was able to stop her. Now that, can they keep him off the cap? Zul coming back up with the Skeletal Mages. ETC landing the Mosh Pit on just Zul. Sonya able to cancel it with the Ancient Spear. Zul landing the Bone Prison on Karzeem, but Zagara is going to cap the Dragon Knight. And Team Red is in a lot of trouble. It was Team Blue taking the lead and then losing it towards the middle game, but now they're coming right back here, and I don't think Team Red's gonna be able to stop this. This is a very powerful Dragonite. It's only gonna be Illidan and Zagara. Toronto will be up in 2 seconds. Zagara landing a huge maul, but there's no follow-up. They've got no range damage here. Other than Zagara, down goes the middle key. Falstad gonna be back up in 11 seconds. Toronto is now back. Can Team Red try to defend this and hold? They've got to. That's a hard task, man. That's a long and hard task. The Dragonite still has 45 seconds left on the timer. Zagara, you haven't used Bolt of the Storm just to get away. I think Zul is gonna be up here in about 20 seconds or so. But here comes the big push. Can Zagara, Taranda, and Illidan hold them off? Here we go. The Dragonite basic attack. Oh, he stopped to fight Illidan. Team Blue trying to burn down the core. Core sitting at 70% and following. Zul's not gonna be up in time. Down goes Sonya. Zagara gets taken out by Falstad. Illidan's gonna fall, and that is going to be the game. What a back and forth struggle. Final total 23-32. Man, oh man. Zul, 195,000 siege damage, although I think that was mostly from the Dragonite. Thank you for watching, everyone. Again, if you have your own replay, send them in Sinvicta316@gmail.com. Make sure you put Almost Heroes in the subject header. Make sure you rename those replays, and also make sure that you give me a little bit of a write-up without spoiling it. Let me know why I should pick your replay, and also try to keep them about 25 minutes or in length or so. If they're a little bit, if you convince me enough, maybe we'll go a little bit over that, but certainly nothing over 30 minutes. So thank you for watching, everyone. Have a great start to your weekend, and of course, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.